Hallo. Why do I look like a displaced participant on a carnival festivity? Because I like to demonstrate you what it takes to work with rhinos and elephants, and that is the outfit we wear when we work with our wild patients. It's also quite convenient because I have to catch a flight at 7 p.m. flying to New Zealand, and if the tide gets short, I'm already in my working dress. On November 22nd, the Washington Post published this article. It's called, "We Don't Need to Save Endangered Species, Extinction is Part of the Evolution." That was published in the category Outlook by an author. His name is Alexander Pyron. He's an associate professor for biology at the George Washington University. And the general statement he makes is, the human society should take only care on itself, not spending any resources for conservation, because nature, with its motor, evolution, will solve all the problems, all our damages, all our eradications. And Mr. Pyron made another quite an interesting citation from an author. Her name is Elizabeth Colbert. She wrote the book, The Sixth Extinction. And this citation is, such as the pain the loss of a single species causes, that we are willing to perform ultrasounds in rhinos and hand jobs in crows. And actually, that is what I do. Except we don't do semen collection in crows, we do it in rhinos and elephants. Why we do it, my team and I? Maybe we think humans can achieve everything. We can walk on the moon, we can explore the Mars, or we can elucidate gravity. So why not saving the most endangered mammoth species, the northern white rhino? There are only three individuals left on our planet. It's a 44-year-old male, Sudan, his daughter, she's 28, and her daughter, Fatu, she was born in 2000. So three creatures of a population which had several hundred thousands when they were discovered in 1908 by a guy, Leidecker. And these creatures are gone from our planet. They are not more present in the wild. They are extremely famous landscape architects in Central Africa. Many species were depending on them. They are gone. They failed in evolution? No. The reason is that the human greed for rhino horn caused that. Combined with extreme criminal activity, these rhinos were killed for the price of their horn. And that means we have to do something. And Mr. Pyron says we should let extinction happen, but we have not the same view. And there's a very impressive book from Douglas Adams, who is better known for his book, Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. He also wrote this impressive book, which honored the northern white rhino with a chapter that was in 1990, when there are still wild northern white rhinos were present in Congo, but now they are gone. So we have three individuals, and these three individuals are infertile. That is another phenomenon the captivity brought to them. So should we give up, like Mr. Pyron says? No, I think we should not. But we have to recognize that breeding in captivity is quite difficult. And you see how difficult it is, you will not get pregnant with this way. So we have to assist, and especially under this situation when we have only three individuals left, and these three individuals are infertile, we have to apply extremely advanced reproductive technologies. How we can do that? We have to combine the most advanced techniques like oocyte collection, in vitro fertilization, embryo production, plus the new techniques coming from the stem cell technology, because we still have tissue cryopreserved in the tanks all over the world, which gives us another access to biological samples. Our colleagues who are working with us, they are mainly based in Japan, they could show that you can make out of a skin cell, you can make oocytes or you can make sperm. So we're working very hard on this together as an international consortium. But before we actually follow that, I want to introduce you a little bit more to our patients, because rhinos are sometimes a little bit difficult to approach. This is an Asian rhino, a Sumatran rhino, which received his hormone injection for the upcoming artificial insemination. It wasn't such a good idea, because we thought we can inject her and she will accept that, but you see what she is doing with us. So it is a little bit difficult. Therefore, we use, in most cases, anesthesia. And anesthesia is quite a good tool to make an animal, a wild animal, calm. However, our patients are black boxes, and they don't tell us their weight, they don't tell us their age, or any underlying disease. So sometimes the anesthesia takes a very unexpected direction, which you will see here. This was a male which hasn't produced any offspring, and during anesthesia, it stopped the heartbeat. So don't try that at home. So we had to be innovative to save its life, because it was a simple medical procedure. And lucky-wise, it worked. So the rhino survived this procedure and woke up. Okay, and the outcome was... The outcome was quite interesting. The reason for this procedure was a semen collection, because he hasn't produced any offspring. Half year later, both female roommates were pregnant. So the explanation was he was afraid to have another of these dramatic procedures. But some of our vet students told us maybe he got a little bit brain damaged and suddenly liked the females. So if you solve the problem with anesthesia, which is a very important part before we can do anything, then we come to the actually assisted reproduction techniques. And one is the oocyte collection in a 2-ton patient. Oocyte collection or ovum pickup is a very common procedure, a million times applied every year in women, horses, cattle. It's quite a standard procedure. But to collect oocytes in a 2-ton patient over 2-meter distance, it's quite challenging. And we developed a new technique going through the rectum because the distance to the ovaries is too far. And going through the rectum with a needle, finding a very tiny follicle, inject that needle, a double lumen needle, into the follicle, aspirate the content, and then dislodge the oocyte. And that is actually what I want to show you here. That is my practical presentation, because the organizer asked for something like that. So I will show you our needle we use. And this is how we visualize the needle in reality. It's an ultrasound scan. And then we find our follicle. And I'm not too excited. And then we harvest our oocyte, and that's the oocyte we normally collect. And with each oocyte, we have half of the embryo to produce new life. And we collect semen, and then we implant that in surrogate mother. That is a very important part of our rescue program for the northern white rhino. However, conservation science does not get much money. Our budget is most likely much smaller than a research group producing ashtrays for prestigious car models. And So we are highly dependent on support from people which believe what we do matters. And here's an example. A very famous Hungarian artist provided us with a painting of a northern white rhino, which we auctioned in Berlin to support our research. So I'm very thankful for that, and I hope that we get even more support for our project. I think we still have a little bit of time, so I present you a different species, which is also quite a challenge because of the dimension, because of the anatomy. Elephants. We worked with elephants for more than 2 decades, and we produced a lot of babies in them. That's looks quite engaged, but I show you that one. So that's some people would say we are a little bit overambitious. I can assure you that's the angle of the camera. That's not how it looks like. It's actually an impregnation process. It's an elephant at the Jerusalem Zoo, and she got pregnant during this procedure. And actually, the biggest award for us, as scientists, is the birth of a baby rhino. And in elephants, we produce more than 50 of them, and we are extremely honored by this success. To finalize my presentation here, there was another quite dramatic publication in 2011 by the group of Bernoski and colleagues published in the prestigious journal of Nature, and they forecast the 6th mass extinction. And I hope our activity will do that, so that the forecast will be not reality and we can change this outcome. And the biggest dream for us is that there will be wild northern white rhinos again in Central Africa. And these wild rhinos will reproduce natural-wise, like they did millions of years before this crisis happened. Thank you very much.